Fuck off. Fuck you. Fuck me.
We have a Harley Davidson Ultra Classic in the shop right now. What we're going to be doing is just a simple Sony GTI 56. Just a little dash modification so that the radio will fit right. Steering wheel control module, which we don't do all the time in a bike situation.
Rastafarian.
Thanks, crew.
Things for me.
Pink one.
The most difficult vehicle, in my opinion, to do steering wheel controls on has got to be a Harley. Four resistors, a combination of eight wires. It's definitely tricky. You got to follow some diagrams. Got it done. Was super stoked when it all worked the first time.
It does it. You can't upgrade it.
Oh, you already got the buttons working?
No.
I haven't done shit. Have a tester, bro. You can't just.
You're gonna test every f***ing wire in the harness?
Yeah, it's right here, right?
Bam. Tell me that's not it.
They don't make a dash kit for the Harley, so you kind of have to improvise. I like to use a piece of MDF. I trace out kind of an outline of the oval circle. And
the oval circle!
Motorcycles forever.
Okay, so I sit in the car. Biker voice.
Just your normal voice would probably work.
Is that a good thing to say? I think that sounded stupid as f.
It did.
I worked on a 2010 Scion Xbox. I installed an Encore E3 alarm. The main purpose the customer wanted was to be able to open the hatch without having to go inside the door and physically unlock it.
What do you think about the Scion?
I think it's for
with girls.
I really like it. It's really nice.
I know there's like a whole religious debate and a holy war going on online about T-taps. And the reason T-taps are good and the reason we use them is because on a car like that, you could T-tap the wire and it's less invasive. So if you're just adding something small like an aftermarket alarm to a factory car, and you use them correctly, you don't have to cut the wire. Everything, if you use the right size T-tap, they fit on the wire. You could take them off at some point if someone down the road wants to change the alarm. And as long as you put them on right and test to make sure it works, and you check it out and you just don't just slap them on and be lazy about it, there's nothing wrong with it.
First I get T-taps and I T-tap everywhere that I'm gonna need my power, ignition, door locks, door triggers, and parking lights. I put T-taps on them. Then I mount my alarm brain wherever it's gonna go. And then I start running wires, and I tape them all off, put my my mail connectors on them, slide them up in that T-tap. And then, yeah, everything works. Works every time.
The horn is only gonna go off when they hit the car, so not when you arm it.
So a guy with a Toyota Sienna was going on a, he said 5,000 mile trip, so he wanted to get a nice stereo going in his van. Definitely is gonna help having some tunes on a long drive. Put the 5-channel V70 Alpine amp underneath the passenger side. I did the radio in the dash.
If you said red salsa and look, hold on. Why?
You probably lost my snap-on drill like you lost my f***ing crimpers.
To get to stepping, throw that away. Do something.
Is my woofer in the box yet, box boy?
This guy.
I was just wondering if I was gonna get the whole job done before you got my woofer in the box, like you said you would. When I do full systems and I have like a time crunch, I need someone to throw a woofer in a box. Jody's my box boy.
They call me box boy. I don't talk. I just don't do it. Like they just talk all day. I'm just the nice guy. But it's cool. I'll help them out. You know, yeah, box boy and bus driver all the time. One or the other. But it's okay. It's okay. I'll just keep being the nice guy. One day it'll pay off. One day.
That's what Johnny said, it never did. Never paid off.
What is it?
Okay. I'll stop.
I love how Rafa does the same thing he gets bitter at me for. Same thing.
Same exact.
What is it? Do you have a 10 mil?
No, I don't. Punch a bit.
So Jordan has a big tool cart full of tools. I don't know why he doesn't like to use any of his tools. He's always looking for mine.
I just want me and you to be friends again.
I mean, we got into a little argument about it. I got mad. I get mad easily. I have a very sensitive heart.
Where is it?
I didn't really get it.
Okay, it was in here, dude.
Look, this is what I was using. With the ratchet.
Okay?
Where's the ratchet?
Hey, you got a 12 in there, Rafa?
But my heart being so sensitive, I forgave him and we just started freaking to some Usher. Was it Usher? It was on Usher Pandora, so it had something to do with a young, sexy black man.
Too close up on the backside.
Nope, don't have it on me. It's just right behind the f***ing head.
Your box board was my soldering iron.
Hey, books boy. You doing my fucking box?
What's up,
books
boy?
You
doing my fucking box, you fucking guy? The big ears.
I wonder if he heard me.
In the box.
I like
professional.
I really like the system in the Sienna with those 6x9s in the front, the Hertz Energy 6x9s. It had a ton of mid bass. Everything was just well matched, perfect amount of bass. It's just a good, clean stereo without breaking the bank. I really liked how it turned out.
Pink is positive for that pussy.
I got distracted, but I'll just cut back in right there.
I don't know what I'm saying, dude. Doesn't even make sense.
The type Alpines. Type Alpine sounded good and stuff.
I was just yoking on you guys.